Photographers, cinematographers, and overall content creators can use lighting, composition, and motion to tell their story. But in this quick video, I'm gonna talk about depth of field and how to use it to your advantage. Hi, my name is Genaro, Senior Pro Market Specialist for Canon USA. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about depth of field. Now, within your images, you can have a shallow depth of field or a deep depth of field. Now, exactly what is depth of field? It is the area within an image that is sharp or in focus. Now, how can you control that depth of field? By knowing how to control your aperture and your focal length. Let's first talk about aperture, which is the opening of the lens. The aperture controls two things in your photographs: the amount of light it lets in, your exposure, and how much of your image will be in focus, your depth of field. The aperture is rated in f-stops. The larger the f-stop number, the smaller the opening. For depth of field though, small apertures give you a shallow depth of field, while larger apertures create a wider depth of field. The second variable that can affect your depth of field is your focal length. Are you using a wide-angle lens or a telephoto lens? In this example, we are going to use the RF 24-70mm f2.8 lens at f4. You can see that the video taken at 24mm has a sharper background than that of the one taken at 70mm. Both these shots were taken at f4, but the 70mm shot has a shallower depth of field. So wide-angle lenses can offer a greater depth of field, and longer telephoto lenses can offer a shallower depth of field. Now, most people think you should always shoot with a shallow depth of field, but for a cityscape photograph like this, it looks great, but you can't really see any details in the buildings themselves. But there will be moments where having that shallow depth of field will give you the look you're trying to achieve. In this setup, you can clearly see all of these hanging LED lights around me, and there's nothing special at all with this image. But once we start utilizing a shallower depth of field, suddenly the image has a completely different look. Now, here are two pro tips on knowing how to decide what size of depth of field you will need for your images. Pro tip number one, what is your background? Do you want to reveal the entire scene to the audience? Images like landscapes are a great example of the use of a deep depth of field. Or are you stuck at a place with a terrible background? Hence, a shallow depth of field will help get rid of any unwanted distractions. Pro tip number two, just how deep is your subject? I'm not talking about an emotional or thought-provoking question. I'm talking about actual measurements. Just how big is the thing you're about to take a picture of? For example, let's take a product shot of this randomly selected digital camera. A rookie mistake would be to just focus on the camera's brand name and shoot it with a wide aperture. But if my job was to show the entire camera kit, this image won't work. I would need to measure the depth of the camera and lens and use that information to help capture the right amount of depth of field I need to have the entire camera and lens in focus. Now, before I scare you off with measurements and math, there are plenty of depth of field calculator apps out there to assist you. All you need is to enter what camera and lens you're using, the distance to the subject, aperture settings, and the calculator will give you back the range of your depth of field. I hope this video was useful in helping you understand a bit more about depth of field. Now, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can be notified when we post up our next Canon Quick Tips. Keep learning, my friends.